Hey Joseph, how excited are you to answer 54 questions today?
Rachel, I'm super excited.
Can you introduce yourself?
Yeah, so my name is Joseph Ravichandran. I'm a second year PhD student here at MIT CSAIL studying computer science.
And what are you working on?
So I work on computer architectural security, which means that I hack CPUs at the silicon level.
Now, when you tell people you're a computer scientist, what are their reactions?
Honestly, most people want me to hack their Facebook account.
So you did expose a security vulnerability on Apple's M1 chip. How did you do that?
Yeah, so the way that worked was we realized that the Apple M1 supports this thing called pointer authentication. And so what we did is we thought, if we were going to make this feature ourselves, what mistakes might we make? What flaws might we add to the system? And we bought one of the M1s and tested it for those flaws, and we found that the mistake that we envisioned was present.
So how did you feel about all of the coverage that this received?
Yeah, so having the incredible support of the community really encouraged us to do future research and made me just more excited to keep working.
So is Pac-Man your favorite video game?
It's definitely up there. It's definitely one of the best.
And what got you interested in hacking?
Yeah, so I grew up making games in Unity, and one day I decided to try to hack my own game. Realized that, you know, it's very easy to make insecure software, and that kind of got me interested.
So what's your favorite type of challenge to hack?
So I work on binary exploitation, which means hacking programs at the low-level assembly language.
And how would you describe ethical hacking to a non-technical person?
Yeah, so ethical hacking means that I'm looking for vulnerabilities in software to disclose them responsibly to the vendor so that I get there before the bad guy does.
Who are some of your favorite researchers you've worked with?
Yeah, one of my favorite researchers to work with here is my advisor, Mengjia Yan. Oh, hey, what's going on, Mengjia?
How's the lab assignment? Does student like it?
Oh, it's been going great. Everyone loves it.
What's your favorite hacking tool or software?
It's a tool called Ghidra that was released by the NSA, and I use it pretty much every day.
Now, what's your favorite MIT hacker prank that's ever happened?
Honestly, gotta be the cop car, which is right up there, actually. And it's a classic. It's super cool.
What's your process for finding vulnerabilities in a system?
Yeah, so there's really two major approaches that I take. The first is something called fuzzing, where you kind of randomly put inputs into a program and just kind of see what breaks. And the second is just looking at the source code and trying to figure out, what did the author miss? What kind of mistakes might they have made?
How do you balance your hacking interests with your academic responsibilities?
Yeah, so luckily as a grad student, most of my academic responsibilities are hacking related. So I get all the hacking I'd ever really want.
What's the most unexpected thing you've learned from hacking?
The most unexpected thing I'd have to say is just becoming very comfortable as a beginner in new things. So with hacking, a lot of the time you're a complete beginner starting with some new technology you've never used. And I found that this skill actually transfers really well to a lot of areas besides engineering.
Common misconceptions?
The biggest misconception is that hacking is an illegal act or a criminal act. Actually, a lot of hacking is done for ethical reasons and actually helps keep you more secure, like the hacking that we do here at MIT.
So have you ever taught anyone else to hack? How'd that go?
Yeah, absolutely. So if you want to learn how to hack, check out our course that we teach that I help design called MIT Secure Hardware Design. So go ahead and Google that and you'll see the course.
How would you explain what you do to a five-year-old?
Hacking computers is basically just tricking them into doing something they weren't supposed to do.
Is there anything in this world that's unhackable?
So unfortunately, I don't think we're quite there yet in terms of the defense technology. We have plenty of innovation left to go. In the meantime, it is kind of fun taking the latest defense innovations and trying to break them.
What's the coolest thing you've ever hacked?
Coolest thing I've ever hacked has got to be the Linux kernel.
Any hacking lingo you can teach us?
Yeah, so I got two words for you. The first is exploit, which means to actually write a hack for a system that makes it do something it's not supposed to do. The second is vuln, which is short for vulnerability. Vulnerabilities lead to exploits. That's the part of the system that's vulnerable to you hacking it.
Were you always interested in computer science?
So I grew up learning programming from YouTube, just watching YouTube videos, and actually even started my own YouTube channel to teach programming to other people.
So what was your reaction when you received the acceptance letter from MIT?
Oh, I was super thrilled. MIT is one of the best places on earth to do research, and I'm super happy to be here.
What was your first day like?
It was pretty overwhelming. I got to see the lab and meet my advisor and meet all my new lab mates.
And how would you describe the community here at CSAIL?
Oh, it's absolutely world-class. Like, if you're interested in some obscure technology and you need an expert on that one thing, there's definitely someone here that knows that.
Are you involved in any clubs here at MIT?
I actually just joined the sport taekwondo team here, which has been a ton of fun. You know, there's really nothing quite like getting kicked in the stomach repeatedly after a long day of research.
Any prominent figures in the field who influence you?
I'm a big Steve Wozniak fan. I was also really influenced by Zaz Brooks and the greater DEF CON community as a whole, as well as Palmer Luckey. As a matter of fact, I was actually one of the very first Oculus Rift backers on Kickstarter.
Hey, you recently gave a talk at the DEF CON conference. What was that like?
Yeah, that was a dream come true. Like I said, I grew up, you know, on YouTube watching DEF CON talks all the time, and getting to be a part of it myself was absolutely super rewarding.
And during your talk, you mentioned memory corruption tasks. Can you briefly explain what those are?
Yeah, so memory corruption attacks are basically just really confusing the computer into doing something that it shouldn't.
All right. Is there an area of computer science research you'd really like to work on, but you haven't yet?
Yeah, so one thing I've never actually touched really is programming language research or writing new programming languages. So it might be kind of cool to work on how do you build a new programming language for security.
Are there some recent research you're excited about?
Yeah, so my group actually just started pivoting more into formal verification, which I think is pretty cool.
Can you tease any future research?
I would love to, but it's top secret.
So if you're stuck on a coding issue, what are your ways to brainstorm or figure out the problem?
Yeah, so a big one for me is hitting the gym, lifting some weights, also going for a walk, or just a nice game of chess.
Are you more productive in the morning or at night?
Gotta be honest, I'm a total night owl.
What's one task you wish was automated but isn't at the moment?
Laundry.
What do you think about this crazy building?
Oh, I absolutely love working here. No, the fact that this place is so great is precisely because it is so crazy. You know, all the crazy turns and twists make you constantly lost, and this means that you're constantly bumping into people that you might not have otherwise. And so this means that a lot of conversations and collaborations happen that you probably wouldn't get in a normal building.
What's more annoying, software bugs or hardware defects?
Definitely hardware defects. So the problem with the hardware defect is that you can't run around putting a new transistor on every chip you've already shipped. So that makes them way worse.
And what's more annoying, a room full of bugs or software filled with them?
Definitely a room full of bugs, because most software already is full of bugs.
Now let's do some favorites, starting with chips.
Apple M1.
Favorite computer science resource?
YouTube.
Favorite computer architecture book?
Hennessy and Patterson.
Favorite class you've taken so far?
Nikolai Zeldovich's security class here at MIT.
Favorite place on campus?
The gym.
Favorite MIT traditions?
MIT Henge, where the light from one end of the infinite corridor lines up and perfectly shines through the entire hallway.
Favorite music that gets you in the zone to do research?
90s rock.
Favorite concert?
Actually, I just saw Blink this past weekend and they were really good.
Best sci-fi movie?
Interstellar.
Best brain food for a long day's work?
Steak.
Favorite restaurant?
El Jefe's tacos are really good.
Dream job after graduation?
Literally anything that just lets me hack stuff.
Where do you see computer architecture and security headed in the next decade?
I'm mostly excited to see where we go with RISC CPUs.
Now, what's one piece of advice from an MIT professor that's really stuck with you?
Yeah, I'd say the most important piece of advice that I've been given is from Mengjia, which is to always apply the scientific method, even in places where it doesn't immediately make sense.
And Joseph, what advice do you have to young students who are interested in computer science and STEM?
Yeah, honestly, just start hacking. Go on YouTube, look up some programming tutorials, and just start creating something. Doesn't have to be good, just start.
Thanks so much, Joseph.
Thank you so much. Now I gotta get back to work. See ya.